When a patient is initially seen in the thyroid center, there are different disciplines within CHOP that they could potentially be referred to.
What we try to do in the process when they come in is go over what's been done, see what questions that they have, and then try to educate them on what these things could mean and what the next step is in the evaluation process.
A patient with a thyroid nodule requires a different level of care depending on whether or not the thyroid nodule has characteristics on ultrasound that look like they could potentially be malignant.
One of the most important parts of addressing any thyroid nodule is to make sure the family understands by definition having a nodule doesn't mean that this is absolutely going to be malignant or it requires surgery. And that's part of the reassurance because not all nodules are malignant, and actually majority of nodules tend to be benign.
If those nodules are something to worry about or not, then is a matter of evaluation.
The first thing that will happen is that a patient will have a thyroid ultrasound, which is an ultrasound of the gland itself and the remainder of the neck, looking for thyroid lymph nodes, looking for other lesions, looking to see how big the thyroid is, and that is performed by our body imaging colleagues. So if the ultrasound is deemed appropriate for a biopsy, then the patient is scheduled for an ultrasound-guided fine needle thyroid aspiration biopsy.
Fine needle aspiration biopsy is our way of determining if the cells within the thyroid nodule appear worrisome under a microscope.
The important thing that we have in place with our interventional radiologists who actually perform the fine needle aspirations, it's all done under sedation. So this is very calming for the family.
The sedation physicians are on site, they meet the family, they come up with a sedation plan with the family.
So it looks like we're gonna give you light sedation. They talked to you about that? Okay. So if at any point you get nervous or you want more, you just have to let us know, okay?
The patient has that expectation that they will be asleep throughout the entire procedure. What that procedure involves is a very fine needle or small bore needle advanced into the lesion of question.
Under ultrasound guidance, so there's someone holding and looking at the nodule and confirming that the needle is going into the right location.
Cells are obtained through the needle, placed on a slide by pathology for review to determine the appropriateness of the specimen.
It's very important having an experienced pathologist available at the time of the procedure, so in real time, she can look at that material and tell the operator, yes, this is going to be diagnostic, or no, I don't think you're in the lesion, or perhaps we should take another pass.
There's a couple of good clumps. It's on pretty high power.
We get very little tissue to look at. It's usually a few cells, but in the majority of cases, that's enough to give the clinicians an indication as to what they're dealing with.
If a nodule is malignant, then the cells that get removed in this process and looked at under the microscope will reveal the diagnosis.
The patient is contacted by our thyroid team to discuss the results.
Sometimes we have to go through the fine needle aspiration process to prove that this nodule is not malignant, and really then at that point you know that you have the reassurance that this is not something that then requires a follow-up by a surgeon and further surgical evaluation. And at the same time, if you have a patient who has a thyroid nodule who you know based on fine needle aspiration is malignancy, then your next step as the provider prior to sending the patient to the surgeon is to make sure what other areas of metastases can be involved.
So because of that, we make sure that we have a staging ultrasound performed by ultrasound techs read by radiologists that are expert at doing these types of exams so that the surgeon knows prior to the operating room what type of procedure they're going to have to use as far as treatment for the patient.